going to read chapter 7 and pulling together. At the bank. Matthew sat in his seat at school. He ran his finger around the empty inkwell. Only the older students got ink in their inkwells. Joe Parker came in. His seat was behind Matthew's. He got ink in his inkwell sometimes. "You're early," said Joe. The boy put two sticks of wood by the stove in the middle of the schoolroom. He had a handful of twigs. "Guess so," said Matthew. "I have to split wood this month," said Joe. "Miss Hall wants a fire these mornings." Matthew did not want to talk about the mornings getting colder. He tinkered with his horseshoe puzzle. Joe opened the stove door and looked in. He turned the handle on the stovepipe. He threw in the twigs and laid in a stick of wood. "What's that you got?" said Joe. "A puzzle." Matthew straightened the chains of the puzzle again and twisted them the other way. "I never seen anything like that," said Joe. He watched Matthew a moment. "Hey," said Joe, "are you coming to the fair?"
"I don't think so," said Matthew.
I thought sure your pa would have his team in the horse pool."
"There's going to be a horse pool?" said Matthew.
"Sure," said Joe. "The bank's putting up a prize. $50. $50?
Joe said, "Sam Johnson's putting his team in, I heard. And that new fella, Bailey. Remember, I told you about his big grays." Matthew nodded.
"Biggest horses I ever saw," Joe said. "And working with Pa, I seen a few. Well, I've got to get a fire from the smithy."
Matthew tried a new twist with the horseshoes. Joe came back. He carried a long, burning splinter. He cupped his other hand around it. He walked straight to the stove and eased the splinter inside. When the twigs caught fire, he stood up. He dusted his hands together.
"Say, Matt, can I try that puzzle?"
After school, Matthew went down to the bank. On the door was a poster. "Cherry Springs Fair and Horse Pool, September 25th, 1912. $50 prize. Were any working team eligible? Inquire within." Matthew could read enough of the words. He went in. A bell on the door jingled. A man behind iron bars looked up. Matthew hesitated.
"Yes," said the man.
I was wondering about the horse pull," said Matthew.
"You have a team?"
"My father does." The man closed a long, flat book and took off his little round glasses.
"Then perhaps your father should come in," he said.
A voice from somewhere behind the man said,
"Who's there, Ted?"
"Just a boy, sir," said the man with the flat book.
An old man appeared from behind a wooden railing. He had white hair and wore a vest.
"Hello, son," he said. "Want to know about the horse pool, do ya?"
Yes, sir, said Matthew.
And who are you?
Matthew Briggs.
John Briggs, boy?
Yes, sir. The man held out his hand.
Pleased to meet you,
he said. Matthew shook his hand.
Well, said the man, I'm Mr. Reed. I know your father. How's the barn coming?
Papa and my brother have all the timber cut to trade to Mr. Murphy, said Matthew.
Good, that's good to hear, said Mr. Reed. Now, this horse pull. Any team that's used for work can enter. There'll be a division for small teams and one for large.
And the prize? Said Matthew. The man laughed.
One for each division, he said. $50?
$50.
I want to enter, said Matthew.
There's a fee to enter, said Mr. Reed. $2. Matthew felt an ache in his chest.
Oh, he said. He stepped back. Thank you just the same.
Tell your father about it, said Mr. Reed.
Matthew had no answer. He went back out the door and down the steps. The man came out after him.
This is important to you, is it?
Matthew's words came rushing.
We have to sell Dolly to keep Ben, and I just thought...
His face got red. Papa would not want him telling this. The man stroked his chin.
You know, he said, I was just on my way to have a sign made for the window here. I need to get the bank spruced up for the big fair, some painting and so on.
He looked down at Matthew out of the corner of his eye.
Do you think you might be able to help me for, say, 10 cents a day?
Matthew drew in a rush of breath.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I could come early in the morning, or I could stay in the afternoon, and I could...
All right, said the man. Let's step into my office and work out the terms.